Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. I'm Achintya Joshi and today we are going to be looking at what's inside my camera bag. But before that, I hope you all are staying indoors, staying safe, self-isolating yourself because of the ongoing pandemic of the COVID-19. But let's just take a moment to appreciate what this has done to our environment. The AQI of Gurgaon and Delhi, and I think covering whole of the world, being in the lockdown, the AQI levels have dropped down insanely. So that's a good thing, but at the same time, please self-isolate yourself and stay safe. Before we get into the video, click the subscribe button and like this video.
Let's go!
Welcome back to my channel, and today we'll be talking about this bad boy and what's inside my camera bag. This is the most asked question. Like whenever I tell someone I'm a photographer, they're like, what camera do you use? What lens do you use? So today we'll be talking about my camera bag. But before we get into the camera bag, make sure to check out the prints. I'll leave the links in the description. If you want to purchase some, that would be really helpful. So firstly, talking about the bag itself. It's the LowPro 350 AW Mark II or something, but I've been using this from the past 2 or 3 years maybe, and this has stuck with all of the pain and whatever it gets because I throw my bag a lot and it's really tough, I assure you. So firstly, looking at what's at the top of it, it's my travel tripod, and this is the Sirui. I don't remember the name particularly, but it's with the ball head, and it is really compact and lightweight, so I really like to carry this with me. But actually my camera bag keeps on changing with my trip to trip. Sometimes I'll have the tripod on or I wouldn't have it, but I have it right now because I just came back from my trip to Udaipur. So let's see what else do we have in here. Nextly, on the other side we have my gimbal, which is the Zhiyun V-Bill Lab, which supports my camera, the Nikon Z6, very well. So it's an overall a very sturdy and a very stable gimbal. I've used it a lot. I've used it in my YouTube videos for videos for my clients, but I love it and it has stuck with me since it's going to be an year now. I've been using it continuously and I love to use it. So nextly, let's talk about the laptop, because that stays near my back and it's one of the most safest things inside my camera bag because it's the most protected. So this is the Razer Blade 15 with the RTX 2070 Max-Q. If you want to see a video on this, click the link somewhere right here. I'll link it there. And obviously with the Burberry drip on it, you can't miss this one. Then going to the first zip, which is not the most attractive thing or exciting thing for someone, but it has the charger. Sometimes I carry the Nikon D7100 with me, which is not my primary camera, so I have to carry two chargers. Next, I have some card readers, one for the XQD, one for the micro SD, CF cards and SD cards. Let's keep that aside. Then I have my cable for my card reader and my hard disk, which I'm very happy about is the same for both. Nextly, I like to keep a pencil with me, always helpful, and just to pass some time, pack of cards. Well, I don't smoke, but I like to keep a lighter with me because this is the classic Zippo. You can't mess with this one. So I really like the dragon design on this one. If you can see, I really like the details on this one, and especially the matte black color, the matte black finish on it. One of my favorite things to keep with me. Now let's get into the main compartment and the most exciting one. So that's the basic loadout. I have my main body here. I have my, so we'll just talk about this now. And firstly, starting with the big boy. This is a lens wildlife photographers crave for, and a lot of people want it, but they don't have this one. So this is a 200-500 f/5.6 by Nikkor. Just look at the size of this lens, and it doesn't even have his lens hood on right now, and that's another at least 8 to 10 centimeters, but I don't carry that with me because that's not a necessity. So I love this lens, has been with me from the past 3 to 4 years at least, and it has been performing very well. And for a lens of this size, it has VR in it and normal and sport mode. Then we have focus groups and lock on 200, and there's a lot of things to play around in this lens, and it's a very, very versatile lens. Nextly, as most of you know, I have changed to the Z system, which is the Nikon's latest mirrorless system. So I have to keep this F2Z adapter with me so that I can use all of my glass from my past Nikon cameras. Nextly, I have the old 35mm f1.8 G lens. So this is an F mount lens. That's why I have to keep this adapter with me. And also this lens is also an F lens, so I have to keep that adapter to attach all of this to my Z6. As I told you, I have a Z6, so let's just have a look on this bad boy. I think for a YouTuber, for a hobbyist or anyone, this camera is the perfect camera, and this is the best camera Nikon has ever released. So I currently have Nikon D7100 with me with a few lenses for it, but I think this system, the size, just look at the size of the mount. It's, I think, 55mm. If I'm wrong, please correct me in the comment section. But such a big mount is really, I think, helping with the clarity the S line lenses are providing. So I really think that this is a really great body, and I love to use it. Next is the stock lens which comes with it. I've talked about this in my video. If you want to look at, if you want to see that video, then you can click the link somewhere here. I'll link it there. That video is basically an unboxing of the Z6, the 24-70 f4 lens, and the F2Z adapter with it. I'm sorry if the audio isn't really great, because I don't know how the audio is going to come out, because most of this video is filmed on the iPhone 11 Pro, which I haven't used a lot, but I'm surely looking forward to using it more in my videos. Next, coming to the audio section, I have the Rode VideoMic Go with me. It's a really great lens, a great mic, because no need of batteries, it turns on itself and is ever recording when it's connected to the camera. So there's no ways you can mess up the audio when you have this mic with you. Now let's have a look at the mouse I use. So this is the Razer Mamba. It is actually wired, and if you want to use it wirelessly, you have to carry a dock with you, which I don't carry. So this is an overkill for my work, but I love to use it because it's fun. So I carry it with me. Next, I have a GoPro Hero 6 with me. It's really outdated, as we have Hero 8, but this is Hero 6, but I think it gets the job done. And I have a dual battery charger for this, because the batteries on GoPro literally are nothing. They drain up really, really fast. So I have to keep an extra battery with me. Next to the drone I own and carry with me. So this is the DJI Mavic mouse. It's because the size of it is really as small as the mouse I carry with me. There's not much difference. So that's the biggest thing I love about it, because 2.7K, 24fps, 30fps, that is more than enough for all the YouTube videos I make. with the gimbal protector on, just keep it in my hoodie, just keep this with me, and I'm ready to go and get drone shots of anything. I really love this drone and carry with me at all times. I also purchased the Fly More combo, so I have the triple battery charger, which is really helpful as it turns into a power bank whenever you need it. That's really a smart thing which DJI thought of. Now let's just have a look at not really much exciting things, but are really helpful for a photographer. I have a few extra cables for my chargers, never run out of batteries, so that is why I stress a lot on keeping extra batteries. Then a microfiber is a must, the lens should be clean at all times. Then I have two actually very necessary cables to keep with me at all times. One, as you know, with the red color on, it's the Rode mic aux cable which you have to keep. And this is the Zhiyun's cable to connect my camera to the gimbal, which is absolutely necessary. Next, I have a few SD cards or XQD cards kept in here. And I have a few extra mounts, for example, few tripod mounts and GoPro mounts, because GoPro, that's the best thing about owning a GoPro, is you can stick it anywhere. So to just stick them anywhere, I've purchased a lot of extra mounts for it, another microfiber, a type C cable to keep with you at all times, because that's the one thing which the world is shifting to right now. Sorry Apple, but we have to go type C. And that's pretty much all for my camera bag. I hope you like it. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel if you are something into photography, videography, or like to have fun. Nextly, please have a look at my art gallery. I've linked it down below. If you want to purchase any prints, it would be really helpful for me. Thank you, and I will see you in the next video.
Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy.